Hey folks, welcome to Quantsapp and welcome back to yet another video. In this video, we will learn about hedging strategies for options buying in Nifty and Bank Nifty. Yes, you heard me right. We will go ahead and learn how we can go ahead hedge our options buying positions in Nifty and Bank Nifty. So Nifty and Bank Nifty options, one of our favorite instruments to trade because of the liquidity they offer, the momentum that happens. Everybody loves to trade in Nifty and Bank Nifty. So today's video is about that, but it is not such that you can't use this concept on stocks as well. You can use it, but use it on the highly liquid stocks. So now first I'll explain you the concept of hedge, like what exactly we want to achieve when we are hedging anything. So whenever you are hedging, right, what is a hedge? Hedge is a position that you create to minimize your loss. Okay. So whenever you're hedging, your idea is not to go ahead and maximize the profit. आपका पैसा बनाने का एम नहीं है बाजार में से, बट योर एम इज दैट इफ समथिंग गोज अगेंस्ट यू, यू शुड बी कवर्ड, राइट? यू शुड बी कवर्ड दैट यू शुड लूज लेस. हेज, व्हेनेवर यू क्रिएट एन हेज, ऑब्वियसली यू नो इट इज गोइंग टू टेक सम कॉस्ट, सम प्रॉफिट्स अवे. लेट्स से इफ यू डोंट हेज, यू वुड हैव मेड 50 रुपीज. इफ यू हेज इट, यू माइट एंड अप मेकिंग 30 और 35 रुपीज. ओके, वॉट एवर डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर स्ट्रेटेजी. But you know, you will make less, but whenever you will lose less as well. Because the thing in the market is, you can't say that always we said that the market will go up, that is the reason the market will go up. By the way, term V indicates you and me both. So, humne socha bazaar upar jayega aur bazaar upar jayega hi. That is something which might not happen always. Something might be, you know, going against the, against your forecast. And you should not end up losing a big chunk. So, that is the idea of hedge, and the concept of hedging is to cut down the losses, as simple as it gets. The idea is not to earn more money from the market. So obviously we will try to go ahead and understand a lucrative, like, so the hedges that we will create, we will keep our profits lucrative as well, and we will keep try to minimize the losses as less as possible. So now first thing is why we need an hedge. So options buying, if you just look at a profile of a simple plain vanilla long call. Okay, so let's say I'm selecting 18,000, or let's say 5th of January. Okay, let's say 18,300 strike price call option. So I am creating a simple bullish strategy. So now the thing with this is that someone will ask me, why should I go ahead and hedge this strategy? So the reason why you need an hedge to this strategy is because there is a known loss, there is a limited loss, still you can lose entire amount of it, right? So what is the maximum loss in this strategy? So this is showing us payoff on various levels. So the maximum loss is roughly around 3,975, roughly around 4,000 rupees is what your loss is. So you can lose the entire chunk, right? So first thing is you can lose the entire chunk. Okay. Second thing is if time goes against you, let's say if you hold this strategy for straight 3 days, then this strategy again might become worthless, right? It might not give you returns. So see, even if market goes up by what, 50 points, still you will end up making a loss at the same level, right? Where you will start making profit till expiry, you will start making profit till expiry if market goes above 18,386, which is roughly around, you know, roughly around 180 points from the current level. If 180 points ka TC aata hai, after that you will start making money. That is where your break even would be. Okay. So the second thing is the time, which you all know is known as theta. Okay. And the last thing in this thing is, right, IV fall. So we all know that if IVs collapse, okay, so if IVs collapse, it might take your option premium down. So see, at the same level, I am making how much? At the same level, I am making, if market is at 18,195, I would make 2,159. Now I will ask the app, what would be the impact if IVs collapse by 33%? See, at the same level, I made a loss of 2,927. So there are three things which I need to fix. But now how will I fix this important, right? How will I fix this important and interesting? We will fix it using delta, okay? We will use the concept of delta. We will learn the concept of delta. What does delta tell us? And we will go ahead and fix our strategy accordingly. Okay. So what does delta tell you? So delta tells you one simple thing, that, you know, it tells you how much premium will move due to changes in or change in underlying. Okay, how much option premium will move due to change in underlying is shown to you by delta. So if I just navigate to option calculator tool in the app, just to show you all how exactly it will look like. Now I am calculating an option premium according to 10% volatility. So I hit the calculate button. So I have got to see that, okay, if market is at 18,192 for 29 December expiry at 18,200 call, this would be the premium and this would be the put premium, right? So I will change the expiry now and I want to evaluate the option premium, let's say for Monday, okay? You can calculate any option premium, okay? So now just look at delta. How much delta is? 0.48, okay? 0.48 is delta. So how much my option premium is? 61.89. Okay, so if I move this option, okay, if I want to understand the effect of delta, if Nifty moves up by 10 points, okay, that means if Nifty goes to 18,202, that option should move up by 4.8 rupees, 4 rupees, matlab 4.8 rupees ke aaspaas badhna chahiye wo option. See, from 61.8 something, it went to 66.8, right? So this thing is showing you that delta will tell you how much option premium will move due to change in underlying. Now moving ahead, what does that tell us, right? What does that tell us is something what I will conclude. But delta tells me one more thing which you should keep in mind. Probability of option expiring in the money. Okay, so it will also tell you the probability of option expiring in the money. If in the money option has a higher probability of expiring in the money, that is the reason if you would have seen in the option chain, in the money options ka delta is higher. For at the money option, what is the probability of at the money option expiring in the money? It is 50-50. Either it can expire in the money or either it can expire out of the money. So that is the reason ATM delta, if you would have seen, is always 50. Or 50 or roughly around 50. Okay, 0.5. Out of the money options have a lower probability of expiring in the money, that is the reason that delta is lower, right? So two things delta tells us, and then we will get our hedge. So delta tells us two simple things: how much premium will move due to change in underlying, probability of option expiring in the money. Okay, so if I just go to option chain, just to show you all, so left hand side call option, right hand side put option. So by the way, you can use this option chain tool in our application, which is absolutely for free. You can easily use it, wherein you will get to see the Greeks and all those information as well. So coming back to the concept, so see, ITM deltas have a higher delta, ATM is around 0.5, OTM have a less probability, that is the reason the delta is lower. Now what my hedge is, so my hedge is very simple, that I will go ahead and buy a higher delta strike price call. Okay, a higher delta strike price call is something what I will buy. It can be anything. I will tell you how to optimize this as well. But a higher delta strike price call option is something what we will buy. And a lower delta strike price call is something I will sell. Okay. So now what I'm doing in this scenario is, so let me just undo it. So let's say what I'm doing is I am going ahead and buying this call option, which is giving me a bullish forecast. Okay. And another thing is I am going ahead and selling, let's say, a 18,500 strike price put option, call option, right? I'm sorry, we are going ahead and selling 18,000 strike price call option, right? So what would happen in this scenario? Okay, if we do this, what will be achieved? So one simple thing would be achieved, that you are paying theta over here, which is 8.3 rupees, is something what the theta will decay. So that means if you hold this bought leg standalone, it will cost you 8.3 rupees. But if you sell this leg, that means your seller of the option, if the premium is getting outflowed, that is your profit. And this theta would act like a profit for you. It will provide you a cushion. Obviously, it will not get offsetted, but it will provide you a cushion. So how much it is? 5 rupees. So net where you were losing around how much? Roughly around 8 rupees. By doing this hedge, you are now just losing 3 rupees, right? 8 rupees jaane hi wala tha, but now by doing simple hedge, you will lose 3 rupees. First thing. Second thing is, first you would have lost, okay? You would have lost 125, the entire premium that you have paid. Now, how much will you lose? You will lose the difference between the buy and sell, okay? you will just lose the difference between the buy and sell, which is 125 minus 24, right? Which is 100, right? 100, 101 rupees is maximum you would lose. Obviously, if you do go ahead and do some, some optimization to that, you can go ahead and find the best hedge possible. But the idea is very simple, that theta is something what you would pay in this leg, and the delta is strong. So this has a higher power of giving you money when the market moves up. This thing will take money from you. 18,400 ka option jo hai wo aapse paisa lekar jayega, but let it go. It will take smaller amount from you, right? So net net, you will be on the winning side by paying a net, a very small theta. So let's understand this thing. So you don't need to do anything manually. Just go to architect. This was just for an explanation. Go to architect. Let's say 5th Jan expiry. I'm going ahead and buying a 0.5 delta strike price call option, right? A higher delta call option. And I'm going ahead and selling. Okay. I'm going ahead and selling 18,400 strike price. So let's select the next expiry. 18,400, 450. Whatever suits you is something what we will sell. Okay. Typically, where I will sell is wherever my target is, that is the strike price I will sell. My target is 18,500. I will sell a 18,500 strike price call. If my target is, let's say, 18,450, that is the strike price I will sell. So now if you see my maximum loss is 4,500. Let me just show you this way. So just look at Greeks. You are paying 400 rupees theta on a long call and you would have lost 6,275. But if you are going ahead and hedging this, right? If you are going ahead and hedging this, you would lose a bit less. Okay. You would lose a bit less. Okay. So see, 4,575 is what your losses. And even the theta that you're paying now is just 123. Another thing is Vega. So now see, if Vega, if the IVs also collapse, it will take some premium for you from you, that is for sure, but it will not create a big dent. So again, what the idea of hedge is? So hedge will obviously try to provide you some cushion, right? It will not cover you entirely. It will try to provide you some cushion, and this cushion in the long run, ek ya do trade aap lenge, if you are exiting the market, that might not affect you. But if you are in the market for a long time and if you want to take it as a business, small things, this will add like a profit. Same thing, now coming to the bearish thing, completely opposite of that is you will go ahead and, buy a put option. Okay. In put options, the delta would be negative because as the market falls, the put option premiums, goes up. So they are negatively related. So in put options, what you will do is you will buy a lower delta put option. Okay. That means wo put ka price stays badega. The put options premium will go up fast. You will buy those put options and you will sell out of the money put options, of which the premiums, okay, will move a bit slow, right? So again, the same thing, but you will replicate it using the puts. Now I will show you a couple of things, okay, by understanding it via architect. So how will you hedge a non-directional option strategy? Let's say your forecast is that Nifty might go up anywhere. Okay, go up or down, but there would be some movement happening in Nifty. Okay, so what you can do is, let's say I am creating a long straddle. So what this forecast is, so let me just create a long straddle. Okay. So when I'm doing this, so this is getting generated, right? A V is getting formed. So by this V, what happens is you are getting payoff, exposure of profit on both the side. Now the problem with this is if you hold for 3 days, see if the market remains exactly where it is right now, you would end up making a loss of almost around 3000 to 2899 to be precise, but roughly around 3000 is something what you might end up losing in this strategy. So what you would do is you would go ahead and sell OTM call options, right? Typically 0.25 delta call option is what you will sell. 0.25 delta or 0.20 delta call and put is something what you will sell. Okay. So let's say I am going ahead and selling 18,400 strike price call options. So let's say December expiry. I am going ahead and selling 18,450 strike price call option, or let's make it 500. Okay. So this is, I'm selling it. So what will happen is So the theta again, the problem with the strategy was I am buying both legs. So theta was decaying at a very faster pace, right? And I was getting a big dent. So that is the reason what I did is I went ahead and sold the put options and call options, of which premiums might not move very fast. Okay. Who tells us that? It is shown to us by delta. Okay. So what we have created at the money, 50-50 delta call and puts we have bought. Somewhere around 0.25 delta, 0.2 delta call and puts we have sold. So the premiums of these call and put options will move up a bit fast. Inka bhi badega, but that might not move up a bit fast. And also the strategy gives you an benefit of a very less theta. So you will pay theta over here as well, but you will pay theta, which is very less. Okay. Over here as well, if you see, you will get to see that, okay, it is giving you decent profits, right? Everywhere almost. And 3 days ke baad, see at the same level where you made a loss of how much, roughly around 2,900, you are making a loss of 1,300. And that is the beauty of this strategy. Let's say even if the IVs go up, you are still covered, right? You are still covered. This is a mega positive strategy. You will still end up making money. And talking about the non-directional aspect, so when you are expecting the markets to oscillate, so what you can do is you can simply go ahead and create a strategy such as calendar spread. So we have made a lot of videos on that, but just for participants who are new, what happens is a calendar spread is something where you will sell the closer series strike price option, right? And same strike price ka door series ka call option or put option, whatever it is, right? You will go ahead and buy that, right? The logic of this entire strategy is that the theta for the long dated option will decay a bit slower, and for the current, the close dated option, it will decay faster. So it will give you an oscillating forecast on the market and it will protect you. So we have an entire video made on this, so you can go ahead and watch that. But the idea was, and what we learned is how looking at delta, we can hedge not just the directional strategies, but how we can go ahead and hedge even non-directional strategies. With this, you will not lose the entire chunk. You will pay 2 times, but you will pay less. IV falls, you will be protected, right? To an extent, you will be protected. And that's what will not, you know, give an undefined loss to you. And also the strategies that we built, mathematically, they were also sound, wherein they gave you a, almost a, you know, reward to risk of 1:2. Yes, and you know, that was it from my side. Thank you so much for joining me up till here. If you found this video helpful, do hit the subscribe button, do hit the like button for more such videos. Bye-bye, take care and happy trading.